you could win more than 28 thou on Card Shark. And here's the host of Card Shark, Jim Perry.
Hello there. Welcome to Card Shark. Thank you so much for joining us. And thank you for joining us at home. Thank you. And a very inventive opening poem. We thank Albert E. Thompson of Staten Island, New York, for that poem. Thank you, Albert. And now let's open the board and get to the cards. Dennis and Bettine, if you will, start loading in the cards. We have a game in progress with these card sharks. Becky Greenfield, our champion. Hi, Becky.
Hello, nice to be back.
Good. Won't you tell us again about yourself?
Okay, my name is Becky Greenfield. I'm from Cerritos, California. I have a wonderful husband and a sweet little boy. And I work for the city of Bellflower as a recreation and arts and crafts specialist. And I'm one of triplet daughters.
And I've got to ask you, talking about your wonderful husband. Now, you won our last show.
Oh, is he excited?
$11,600 on one show, and your husband didn't know about it.
I know.
What was his reaction when you told him?
I can't believe it. I can kind of believe it. I don't know what to say. You know, he was just
but
thrilled.
He was happy, huh?
Yes.
Good. Nice to see you again, Beck. Nice and our challenger was Willie Boston. Hi,
right,
Boston.
How are you?
You prefer being called, right?
Right.
Boston. Why don't you remind us about yourself, Boston?
Okay, Jim, my name is Willie Boston. I'm originally from the state of Louisiana, living in the city of Los Angeles now. I'm a school teacher for the Pomona Unified School District, and I always tell anyone that I'm the best teacher that I know. And the grades that I teach is history and sociology.
How do you know you're the best teacher?
Well, once a year, we elect the Teacher of the Year. And I've been lucky enough to win it right down the years for the past 5 or 6 years.
Oh,
so that tells
nice.
Me that, and this has been elected by the students.
That's very good. Right. Good to have you back.
Thank you.
Good luck to both of you. Each player has a deck of 52 playing cards. They're shuffled. The players cut them before we go on the air. And Becky, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Boston, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. Before he can begin calling high-low on the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question. And as we left off, Boston, the question goes to you. Best 2 out of 3. We're in the middle of game one. We asked 100 women, have you ever left a beauty salon in tears because of the way your hair turned out? How many women said, yes, they have?
I think there have been quite a few who have left in tears because the hair didn't turn out right, but I would say at least 37 left in tears.
37 left in tears the way their hair turned out, Becky.
I've done that more than once, and I know it's a lot higher than that.
Higher than that?
Yes.
If it is higher, Becky, you'll go to the board first. If not, it'll be Boston. And the actual number of women who have left a beauty salon in tears because of the way their hair turned out is 55. It's higher, Becky. Yes.
Hi.
Becky, we left off with a jack as your base card. Whenever you win the question, you have the right to change it.
I'm going to keep that. And I'm going to bet the next card is lower.
Lower than a jack, she says. And she's right.
That's a good
three.
Card. All right. Okay, the next card's higher than a three.
Risking that one and this one higher.
Yes.
Another jack.
Okay, the next card's lower.
We're going to take the risk. Lower than a jack. It is three. Jack three, jack three. For the bundle for the first game in the match. If this is higher, yeah! And just like that, the champion is game one and $100. Game two coming up in a moment. Right now, let's make a little money for the house. Don't go away. And we're back with the champion leading 1-0. Set up for game two. Same two decks of cards. And the question goes to you, Becky. We asked 100 married women, have you ever said to your husband, you don't love me anymore? How many married women have said,
I think
you
there's
don't love
a lot
anymore?
Of insecure women around. I think it's going to be pretty high. I'd say 74.
74 women have said, you don't love me anymore, Boston.
I think there are quite a few women who have made that statement, but I'm going to say just a little lower than 74.
A little lower.
Right.
All the women out there saying higher, higher.
They know.
The actual number of married women who have said to their husband, you don't love me anymore, is 55. It's lower, yes.
Yeah.
Only 55.
Right.
Boston, your base card is A king.
Oh, I'll keep that one there, Jim. The next card is lower.
Lower than a king. Yes, the 10.
I'm going to freeze.
Freeze it right there. We moved the freeze bar over.
Right.
Can't take those cards away from you. Boston, we asked 100 men. If you were seated next to a nun, now picture this one. Mm-hmm. If you were seated next to a nun on a long plane flight, there she is in her black and white habit, and the only magazine you had with you was Playboy. Would you be too embarrassed to read it? How many men said they would be too embarrassed to read Playboy in front of the nun?
Well, on a long trip like that, they would probably be embarrassed for a while, but then it would wear away. I still say that the number would be probably about 47.
47 right. Would be too embarrassed to read Playboy in front of the nun.
I think it's a lot higher than that.
You say higher than
yes.
that? The actual number of men who would be too embarrassed to read Playboy is 47, right on the button. Wow.
Right on the knee.
My goodness. You've got a 10. Do you want it?
Jim, I would like to change that card.
And you can. You won the question, changing the 10 to, oh, an 8. Not a good change. You're right up the middle.
Okay, I'm going to say the next card is lower.
Lower than an 8? No, it's a jack. And it's not lower. And we just take you back to the freeze bar, and Becky gets a chance to play a queen.
Good card. Lower.
Lower than a queen? That's a jack. I mean, I'll go higher if you want, Becky.
No, you know what I meant.
Lower than a jack. Yes, a 6.
I'm going to freeze.
Freezing with that one card advantage will fill in the space for Boston there. I did a double take. Higher, really?
That was a tough
Becky, we asked 100 women. Would you wear a pair of painfully tight shoes if they made you look really great? How many women said they would wear
I have them on right
shoes?
Now.
Oh, yeah? Let me see the shoes. They don't look plain. Come over here so we can see. They don't look painfully tight.
Well, they're not super comfortable. I have some better ones.
Oh, okay. Well, how many said they would wear the painfully tight shoes besides you?
72.
72 would wear the tight shoes to look good, Boston.
I think the pain would overshadow the good looking here, so I'm going to say it would be probably just a little lower.
A little lower.
Right.
Yeah, it's comfort first.
Comfort first.
The actual number of women who would wear painfully tight shoes if they made them look really great is 19. It's much lower, Boston.
Right.
Do you want that 8?
No, please. Take
eight,
that away.
8-2. A 4. Good
okay,
chance.
That's better. The next card is higher.
Higher than a 4. Yes, a 6.
Okay. The next card is higher.
Higher than a 6? It is a jack.
All right. The next card is lower.
To tie up the match, lower than a jack?
Yes!
And we are tied at 1-1. We'll set up for the tiebreaker. Each player with one game and $100. And up on the board for the tiebreaker, just 3 questions. Here, 3 cards there. Question to you, Boston. We asked 100 people. If the FBI asked to use your house to spy on your next-door neighbors, would you let them?
Boy, that's a tough
How many one. People said they would let the FBI use their house?
I don't think too many would actually let the FBI use their home to spy on their best friend.
Their next-door neighbors.
Their next-door neighbor. Oh, their next-door neighbor. I would say about 51.
51 would let the FBI use the house, Becky.
I think it's probably a little bit higher.
Higher. The actual number of people who would let the FBI use their house to spy on their neighbors is 47. It is not higher, Boston. And again, making a good choice, Boston, you start with a 7.
I would like to change that card, please.
Next card off the top of the deck is a queen.
Okay, great. The next card is lower.
Lower than a queen? Oh, no, it's a king. It is not lower. Big break for the champion. Becky will play an ace.
Ace, that's a good one. Next card is lower.
Lower than an ace. Yes, a 7 now. You got a big decision. You're right up the middle.
Freeze. I'm going to freeze.
You're going to freeze it. Becky needs 1 card. Boston needs 2. Someone's going to get a crack at the money cards. Becky, we asked 100 people in Portland, Maine. Do you owe anybody any money? How many people in Maine said they did owe somebody money?
I don't know any people that don't. So I would say about 97.
97 people in Portland, Maine owe somebody money.
I know there are quite a few people who owe money, but I think it would be just a little lower.
Lower.
Right.
The actual number of people in Maine who owe somebody money is 55. It's much lower. Boston. You want that queen?
I
want
to keep that card. And the next card is going to be lower.
Lower. Right. Lower. All right. You want to turn the microphone around, Boston, so we can hear you there?
Oh, thank you. I'm a little excited. Much, yeah.
I know you want to get comfortable.
Right.
Lower than a queen.
Yes, a two.
All right.
Higher.
For the championship, higher. It is the new champion.
And
Becky, you are leading with $11,700.
I can't complain about that. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Becky Greenfield, Boston, come on down here. Can't believe it, huh? Congratulations. Boston is not only going to prove he's the best teacher, he's going to make the most money ever right after this. I hope so. Back with our new champion, Willie Boston, and again, our congratulations. Are you a gambler, Boston?
Sometimes, not often. You know, being married with a family, you can't afford to gamble too much.
Good thinking. Let's see if we can make some money for the family right now. Let's get to the money cards. Come on up here. Well, you were $200 in the game, yours to keep. Now we're going to give you a brand new deck of cards, all shuffled and cut. New money to play with, and you're going to bet it. Starting on the bottom line, we'll give you $200 and three cards. Move up to the second level, we give you another $200 of betting money. Three more cards. Your minimum bets, remember, are $50 until you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half the money. We want you to take it away. Here's $200.
All right.
As in the game, you have a choice of two base cards to start with. Remember, you can change your base card when you move to the second level, and you can change your base card before you make the big bet. We're going to start off with right now... Oh, yes, a two.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh. I'll bet the whole thing that the next card is higher.
The whole thing.
Right.
$200. Higher than a two. It is a 10.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to bet 10s are not too good to me. I'm going to bet $100. The next card is lower.
$100 bet.
Right.
Lower than a 10. No, it's a king. Got a better card out of it, though, Boston.
All right. I'm going to bet all of it that the next card is higher. I mean, lower. Lower.
Lower.
Still excited. Lower.
Okay, lower.
Right.
$300 lower than a king.
Yes!
What a five. Up goes the five. We'll give you the other $200 of betting money. You've got $800. Do you want the five?
I think I would like to change that five.
See if we can make a better change to...
A jack! Yes! I'm going to bet $400 that the next card is lower.
Big bet, half of the money on a jack.
The next card is lower.
$400 lower than a jack?
No!
Doc Queen, you're down to $400 looking at a queen.
Okay, I'm going to bet $400 that the next card is lower.
This one's got to be there. $400 bet lower than a queen.
Yes! Yeah!
Now you're cooking. $800 and a seven.
Right.
Two cards to go.
Okay, seven is not too good to me, Jim. I'm going to bet again $100 that the next card is higher.
$100?
Right.
Higher than a seven?
No, it's a three.
But it gives you a pretty good card to move up there for the big bet, Boston.
All right.
You've got a three.
Okay, I'm going to bet the whole thing that the next card is higher. Higher.
Everything.
Right.
Big bet.
Yes, higher.
$700.
Has to be.
Nothing or $1,400
right.
Higher than a three. It is.
Yeah.
Good comeback.
Yeah.
That's not bad. You had two cards fail you, and you come out of it with $1,400.
Right. No.
Come on down here. And with the $200 in the game, that's $1,600.
Great.
We'll meet a new challenger right after we take time out for this, so don't go away. Okay, Boston, let's get set for the next match. Two brand new decks of cards and a new challenger on Card Sharks. Diana Jarrett. Hi, Diana.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to be here. Thank you.
Won't you tell us about yourself?
Yes, I'm Diana Jarrett, and I'm married. My husband works in recreation, and I teach school in Lakewood, third grade, and I have two darling 2.5-year-old twin boys.
Well, good. Nice to have you here with us.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Good luck in the match.
Thank you.
You'll play the lower cards, Diana, the blue cards, Boston the champion, the upper cards, the red cards. Boston, we took a nationwide survey of women who have 10 or more children. And we asked them, right now, if you could snap your fingers and have twice as many children, would you do it? How many women said they would want twice as many children?
Okay, I don't think too many women would want twice as many children as they, in fact, they probably wouldn't want the 10. So I think the number would be probably maybe five.
Five, right. Would want twice as many, Diana.
Oh, he made it really hard because I know my two just drove me crazy at times this summer, staying home with them. Oh, he made it really hard. But I maybe just a teeny, teeny bit higher.
Teeny, teeny bit higher. The actual number of women with 10 or more children who would want twice as many children is 22. It's higher, Diana. Yes. Yeah, if they've got a bunch, I think they probably like them. And Diana, you're starting with a 7.
Change it, please.
Changing the 7 to a queen. Good change.
Okay. Next card, lower than the queen.
Lower than a queen.
Okay.
Yes, an 8.
Good. I better freeze on that 8.
Freezing with that middle card, and the question goes to you, Diana. We asked 100 college men, if you were offered a job paying $20,000 a year, would you quit college right now to take it? How many college men said they would quit college to take the job?
I'm afraid in this day and age when they need some money that I think they would quit even if they thought, oh, I'll go back later. So I would say high, 62.
62 would quit college to take that $20,000 a year job, Boston.
Okay, Jim, I think the number would be lower considering college versus $20,000 now. I think
you
it would
say
be lower.
Lower. The actual number of college men who for $20,000 a year would quit college to take the job is 20. It's very much lower, Boston. Yes. And your base card, Boston, is a 10.
I would like to change that.
Changing the 10 to?
Oh, okay.
Yes, a 2, a great change.
Next card is higher.
Higher than a 2. Another 2. It's not higher, Diana. A chance to play off the 8.
Oh. Play off the 8, I'm going to try lower.
Lower than an 8?
Oh!
Right, a 4.
Okay, higher.
Higher than a 4? Yes, the queen.
Okay, lower.
For the first game of the match, lower than a queen, it is a 9. Game 1 to the challenger. We'll set up for game 2, Janice, if you will. Good job there, Diana.
Oh,
we opened the door for you and you took advantage of it. So it's game 1 of the challengers, same 2 decks of cards. Janice deals them out, and the question to you, Boston. We asked 116-year-old boys, be honest, when you go to a school basketball game, 16-year-old boys, do you pay more attention to the cheerleaders than you do to the game? How many 16-year-old boys admitted they pay more attention to the cheerleaders?
Okay, that age, I suppose they would pay more attention to the cheerleaders. I would say about 25 pay more attention to the cheerleaders.
25 pay more attention to the cheerleaders, Diana.
Oh, no, I really think they're interested in the game, but those cheerleaders, basketball?
16-year-old boys at a school basketball game.
I think it's got to be a little bit higher, but I really don't think that many.
Because it's basketball. How about if it were football?
Football, I think they pay more attention to the game.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay. The actual number of 16-year-old boys who pay more attention to the cheerleaders than the basketball game is 68. Diana, it's very much higher. Oh, yes.
Let's see.
16-year-old boys. Diana, you've got a jack.
Okay, I'll keep it and go lower.
Lower than a jack.
Oh.
Yes, with an 8.
I'm in a freeze.
You're freeze, taking that one card advantage over Boston, who needs this game. Can he win it? Well, we'll have to wait and find out. Right now, we're going to take time out for this. That's all the time we have for now. We'll have to finish this match when next we meet. For now, I just hope you have a very good day and come back and see us next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
One of our polling groups will receive the Amana Touchmatic 2 Radar Range Microwave Oven, featuring an automatic temperature control system that cooks any cut of meat moist and tender, made and furnished by Amana. And some of our contestants will receive an assortment of exciting Maybelline eye, face, and nail cosmetics featuring new nail color. Protects and colors nails instantly, furnished by Maybelline. And you can give Roman Brio men's fragrant gift sets this Christmas. Roman Brio cologne and aftershave available in regular or leather scent. And a selection of Tenti products, the great new building set from Hasbro. With Tenti, it's a snap to be a better builder. And Smooth and Silky by Remington, the electric razor for women that we believe shaves as well as a blade. The Remington Smooth and Silky. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. We'll be right back.